morning again, Baycroft. Are you ready for Rainbow Day Part 2? You must be excited if you watched yesterday's, because we had so many group challenges set for us, didn't we? And today we've got even more, so I'm so excited. Now, you may have noticed Miss found another bright coloured hoodie, gone for yellow today, and it may surprise you as much as it surprises me that I own this much bright clothing, because let's be honest, all I wear at school is black. So maybe when we go back, you'll start seeing me in brighter colours, or maybe not. But for Rainbow Day today, bright yellow is the way forward. So what have we got in store today? We've got science-based challenge, we've got a PD-based challenge, and we've got an art-based challenge. And also, I'll let you into a little secret. There's a bit of a surprise at the end of the video just for you guys. Now that means you need to watch the whole thing, because you're not gonna wanna miss anything today, okay? So, enough from me. I'm gonna stop babbling at you. Let's see what we've got in store today.
Normally, when we look outside at the sky, we only see a few colours, blue if it's a nice day, or grey or white if it's a cloudy, rainy day. But every so often, we get to see a rainbow. But what do you know about rainbows? Where do they come from? How are they made? Is there really a pot of gold at the end? Well, for a long time, no one really had any idea where they came from. But scientists noticed that glass objects, especially those with flat surfaces, would sparkle with rainbow colours when they were placed in sunlight. They found the best rainbows came from glass prisms. Our good friend and discoverer of gravity, Sir Isaac Newton, wondered if there was a connection between rainbows in the sky and the ones in prisms. He tested this by placing a prism in front of a single sunbeam in a dark room, and it created a rainbow. But how did it do that? Was the prism creating the colours? Some people thought that it was, but Newton thought that maybe sunlight was a mixture of all the colours in a rainbow. He thought that if this was the case, then maybe the prism was separating the white light into all of the colours of the rainbow. But that doesn't make any sense, right? Because if you mix all the colours of paint together, you just get brown. But maybe light is different, Newton thought. So Newton tested this out by placing a second prism facing the other way in front of the rainbow from the first prism, and he got white light again. So Newton proved that rainbows are created by sunlight. This is because sunlight is a mixture of many different colours, each with a different frequency. White light can be split into a spectrum of these colours using a prism. When light enters the prism, it is refracted, and each colour is refracted by a different amount. This means that the light leaving the prism is spread out into different colours, and this is called dispersion. The seven colours of the spectrum are listed in order of their frequency. And here are the seven colours: red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. These are listed in order of their frequency, from the lowest frequency of red to the highest frequency of violet. Highest frequency just means most waves per second. But that hasn't solved the mystery of why rainbows appear in nature, because we don't have pieces of glass floating around in the sky, do we? Well, we don't have pieces of glass, but we do have this, water. Raindrops can do similar things to prisms. When we see sunlight shining onto water droplets, we see a rainbow. This is because water acts in the same way and separates sunlight into each colour. And it's not just raindrops. You can find rainbows with any water, waterfalls, watering cans, or even your garden hose. So here's some rainbow practicals and a challenge for you. Can you make a rainbow using water? If you're lucky enough to have a garden and your parents or carers don't mind, make sure you ask. Why don't you see if you can make your own rainbow in the garden and ask them to take a photo of it? If you're like me and don't have a garden, here's some experiments you can do in the kitchen.
The first experiment I'm going to do is using Skittles and hot water. You can use cold water, it just works a little bit slower. And if you are using hot water, please make sure that you are being supervised by an adult. So I'm just going to take my hot water and I'm just going to pour it in the middle. Plate, and then we just wait for our rainbow to grow. If you have any spare Skittles left from the first experiment, you can separate them out into each colour and put them into a glass and then add some water to it. After a little bit of time, the colour of the water will change depending on what colour Skittle you put them in. Now, if you get some strips of kitchen roll and place one in each colour, bending into the next one, you should be able to create a rainbow. And then once you've waited a little while, the water from each cup should have travelled up the kitchen roll and gone to the next piece of kitchen roll and created a little rainbow. You have to be really patient with this one, it does take some time. For the last experiment, you just need a glass of water and some plain paper in some direct sunlight, and you simply pick up your glass of water and aim it towards the sunlight and you should get a nice rainbow. So see if you can try this one at home and see if you can get any better rainbows than I can.
Morning Baycroft, Mrs. Wales here. Your art challenge today is linked to the artist Andy Goldsworthy. Some of you Year 8s might remember looking at his work this year.
Andy makes sculptures with natural materials in the UK and around the world. He has made them in forests, fields, cities and lakes. They are known as land art. Which natural materials can you think of that he can use to make sculptures? Maybe leaves, twigs, pebbles, rocks, ice, flowers, grass, pine cones. Andy thinks we often forget that we are nature. Andy Goldsworthy's art makes us think about the world around us and how nature is art.
So your art challenge today is to make a rainbow in the style of Andy Goldsworthy. So first, collect your natural materials in some pots or bags or any containers and sort them into different colours or tones. Okay. And then find a sheltered area to work in, not too windy. So either in your garden or when you're on your daily walk. You can use chalk to draw your rainbow out first, or even a stone. Or you can just start creating to produce something a bit like this. Outside, you could always use natural colours from the kitchen, some fruit and vegetables, but remember to ask a grown-up first and take care if you're using a knife or a grater. So you can produce something a bit like this. Rainbow or prepare for as a snack for a family member, but remember to take a photo first. Yum. Now you have a go, and you might want to have a look at Andy Goldsworthy's work and create some more land art too. So really looking forward to seeing your work. Send your photos into the Baycroft Home Learning site and happy rainbow making.
Hello, and today we're going to be making a rainbow Wordle. Now, what is a Wordle? A Wordle is a collection of words arranged to form an image. They can be about anything, like sport or education, and can even be organised into different shapes, like a bird or apple. Today, we are going to be creating one in the shape of a rainbow. You can either do this using paper and coloured pens, or using a website called wordart.com. This is what I'm going to be showing you today. Okay, so when you type in the website, this is the screen you arrive at. Click on Create. Now the first thing we need to do is input the words you want to see in your Wordle. The rainbow Wordle we are making today is going to be a visual representation of your lockdown experience. So your words are going to be about you and what you have done, you felt, or you have experienced during this time. This means that everyone's Wordle will look different because you've all experienced different things. First, delete these words here and start with putting your name. This means we'll know who it belongs to. And then start listing below different activities you have done. So for me, I've spent time reading, baking, walking my puppy, completing jigsaw puzzles, watching Netflix and Disney Plus, gardening, going for runs, and so on. List as many different activities as you can think of. The more you write down, the better your Wordle will be, but try to keep them to single words as much as you can. Now you've got your activities down, I want you to think about the different feelings you have felt during your lockdown. There might be quite a few of them. I know I felt lots of different feelings during this time. But to help me, I used this feelings chart. Just enter your feelings in the same column, listing as many as possible. Once you've entered all the words you want to see in your rainbow, we get to the exciting bit, choosing the shape. Now, there are two ways of doing this. You can search rainbow in this box here and select one of the shapes below, or save a different image of a rainbow from Google onto your computer and select it by using the Add Image button. I chose an image from Google to show you what this looks like. Just click OK, and then we are ready for the magic. Click on the Visualize button to see your Wordle brought to life. It might take a few seconds for the magic to happen, but then you can see your chosen words and shape represented on the right. You can either leave it like that or have a play with the different fonts or layouts of your Wordle, remembering to click Visualize after each change. Once you're happy with your rainbow, click on Download, then select Standard JPEG and save it as your name onto your computer. Mine is called Miss Carpenter's Rainbow. And that's it complete. Your rainbow is finished. What a fantastic job you've done. I can't wait to see them all. Speak to you soon. Bye.
This story is called The Rainbow Serpent, and it's based on a traditional Aboriginal story. Long, long ago in the dreamtime, the earth lay flat and still. Nothing moved and nothing grew. One day, a beautiful snake awoke from her slumber and came out from under the ground. This snake was known as the Rainbow Serpent. She travelled for a very long time, far and wide. As she made her way across the land, her body formed mountains, valleys and riverbeds. The Rainbow Serpent was the dreamtime creature who shaped the earth. After all of her travelling, she grew tired. She curled up and began to sleep. After some rest, she returned to the place where she had first appeared and called out to the frogs, "Come out!" The frogs woke up very slowly because they had so much water in their bellies. The Rainbow Serpent tickled their stomachs and the water began to fill the tracks that the Rainbow Serpent had left. This is how the lakes and rivers were formed. After this, water, grass and trees began to grow. All the other animals that lived in rocks, on the plains, in the trees and the air, began to wake up and follow the Rainbow Serpent. They were all happy with the earth. The Rainbow Serpent said, "Those who obey will be rewarded. I shall give them human form. But for those who don't, they will be punished and turned to stone." The tribes of the people lived together on the land given to them by the Rainbow Serpent. They knew that the land would always be theirs as long as they took care of it. They believed that no one should ever take it away from them.
drop high above the chimney top. That's where you'll find